can't stop me from rapping, can they? Can they hop? I spit it through the wire, man.
Like, it's my job to make sure that they know when they have a desire to be great, if they will work towards it, if it takes them forever, at least they're trying. Mm-hmm. So I'm there to push the encourager, you know, to try to find every resource that I can. We've helped so many children get into college. Yes, and that's because when I went to the University of Alabama, let me tell you this quick story. Back in 1993, well, in 1992, I actually was accepted in December of 1992, which was back then was like a huge thing. There was no internet, you know, there was no, you know, applying online. Everything was pen and paper. And so I can remember my teacher, a couple teachers and guidance counselors, like, oh, you know, you need to go to Alabama A&M, which is nothing wrong with that. Like, seriously, like, had I to do it all over again, I probably took a scholarship at A&M, you know. But let me just say that was my desire, to go to University of Alabama. And essentially, I had no guidance on that, you know. My mom had went to Calhoun, but, you know, I really didn't know. And she didn't know. We didn't know anybody to call and say, hey, how do you do this FAFSA? How do you, you know, fill this out? So I just promised God, if you will let me get through this, I promise you, if there's ever a child that needs help, I will be that one.
Oh, wow.
That was my promise to God. And when I was in a senior in high school, I can remember saying, God, you know, if you will just help me to make it through some of the situations I was dealing with as a teenager back then. It seemed like the world was coming to an end. I was like, I was like, God, if you will help me get through that, I will help somebody else. So I kept making God those promises. And so as I kept making God those promises, I realized that, hey, he was keeping his end of the bargain.
Yeah, you gotta keep yours.
So I had to keep mine. And so now, you know, here I am. Like I said, 25 years. I hope to... 25 years from now, I will be 70. You know, I will be 70. Yes. And I hope I can be like Cicely Tyson, still doing my thing. Still hopefully in good shape, good health.
You will
be. And still making a difference, even if it's on, you know, a political side. Who knows where life will take me.
And you know what? That's the beautiful thing of life. You never know how it's going to take you.
Right.
In my mindset, football would last forever.
Right, absolutely.
Or I knew it would end, but I would always be in that realm of football as a coach, as a recruiter, as this or that, or a TV analyst doing it, you know.
Absolutely.
Which I'm not ruling anything out, but, you know, that's why I saw it. I didn't see my career path. I didn't see myself sitting here doing this.
Right.
Especially talking, interviewing anybody, being articulate enough to move a conversation, none of that, you know. So to be in this position, I understand exactly what you're talking
about. Of digital media.
Yes.
And I'm learning some of those things even in my PhD study, learning how children, cyberbullying is huge.
Oh, man.
It is major. Dealing with children and them being on YouTube and learning so much, being able to Google so much. So the music, videos, all these different streaming services and apps, it is draining. I'm gonna be honest with you. And my word to parents is you need to pray and ask God to teach you how to handle some of these things. And then of course come to professionals like us that can give you strategies and ways to deal with it. But one thing is being very direct with children. I think they respect the language of truth. You know, and so Brandon and I are very upfront and forward and teaching them, hey, so this is what you want to be. This is how you're going to get there. And unlike when you and I were in school, you don't have time to play. I mean, you can even see from the athletics, things have changed, I'm sure. But when you went to Bama, now, I mean, you got to work really hard to get there now, you know, or to finish college or, you know, whatever else. So, teaching them how to have a work ethic and be good, responsible citizens. So all of those things are going to make a difference. But, I'm learning to really, really, really meet them where they are and just be straight up on it.
What last thing here? Okay. Since you said cyberbullying, I gotta hit this.
All right.
Cyberbullying is a big thing. Yes. It's going on, and it has become its own movement.
It is.
And rightfully so. If you had to diagnose, you had to deal with.
Okay.
The president of the United States, President Trump. Do you feel like he is an advocate of what the world is saying not to do as being bullying? It's like he has a lot of ethics of things that he constantly bullying. Somebody don't like him, you tell him shut up. Hey, uh-huh. you're bad this, you're bad that, you know. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Quickly, dude, uh-huh. to shut it down. He like to take his position from a power position and have a kind of tantrums.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Do you think that was bullying? What he does is bullying. How do you handle something like that? I know you got to be politically correct,
okay,
but I'm going to ask you this question.
Let me just say that I think that we are dealing with a time where, so our president came, he came from a business background, mm-hmm. okay? Whether my political views are for him or against him, let me just say he's a businessman, mm-hmm. right? Have you ever Googled the number of businesses the president has? It's like
I have
tons of them.
Yes.
Like everything. Yes. Yes. So he came from that. He also came from a reality TV show world. Mm-hmm. Okay. And he's a billionaire. So he's lived a very privileged lifestyle. I think there may be a disconnect from the average American there, you know. Mm-hmm. So then you have the Obama age. So you came from, you know, the Obamas who were very, you know, soft and politically correct, and you know, you saw the family dynamic, and then you come to the age of, you know, President Trump, where they're polar opposites. Okay, so mm-hmm. I think in and of itself, we're all in a shock and awe, you mm-hmm. know, especially as an African American, I can just say, like, wow, he actually said that. Wow, mm-hmm. he said that, you know, President Obama said that, you know, what would the media say? Right,
might act officially get killed,
right?
Tomorrow.
Right,
yeah.
So mm-hmm. you have that divide, yeah. and so, I will say that as our leader, does he always show good example to children? I mean, if a child were to act the way our president behaves sometimes, I think, you know, they may be put into detention or, you know, suspended from school.
Yes,
you know,
yes.
So is it for me to say that he is showing a good example? Well, my children are grown, so mm-hmm. they are able to make their own choices. For as far as parents, you know, they really don't have a choice. He's the leader of our country.
Yes.
But as far as cyberbullying is concerned, I will say that adults in and of itself, whether it's from the White House to my house,
tweeting all
this, you know, we have what we call in the psychology world, keyboard terrorists.
Yes.
So people can get on there, you know, and are really empowered
behind
social media,
yes.
because, you know, you have that human divide. Would people say in reality the things that they say online?
Mm-hmm.
Probably not. Why? Because, you know, you run the risk of threat of getting mm-hmm. shot mm-hmm. or, mm-hmm. you know.
And you have no protection. You said it in front of somebody.
Right.
It's in face to face, and like he can say certain things.
Mm-hmm.
You miss around touching, you're gonna get blasted. You're dead.
Absolutely.
You
know? Absolutely.
You know? So, even in
absolutely.
That aspect, it changes the
absolutely.
Game. But yes.
Yeah, so I'll be honest with you. You were to say to me, how do I handle what our president says? A lot of times it's comical. And the reason mm-hmm. why is because I just, you know, obviously all the things I have going on,
mm-hmm.
you know, I'm only watching the news right now because of coronavirus is mm-hmm. really controlling the businesses that
yes,
I am involved
yes,
in.
Yes.
If it was not for that, I don't really get into media. And I was actually a broadcast news major at University of Alabama.
Oh,
so
okay,
I kind of
okay.
know the back, you know, so I know that things are edited and filtered.
Yes.
Obviously, the president has an administration that is leading the charge on something,
mm-hmm.
but he just bluntly, and then for his age, he just says, you know, you think about our grandparents or whomever, they just get to an age and say what you want.
Yeah.
I just think he don't have a care about some things and what you think about it. Because
yeah,
after all, what
is.
Can we really do?
Yeah.
You know, so,
yeah,
so I take it in all humor. And I have never agreed with every administration on anything. I'm just going to be honest with you. There were things in the Obama administration, being the first African American. I love that. My First Lady Michelle Obama, I absolutely loved. And her dress code was fire. Okay.
Yes.
And so is Melania Trump. Do I agree with their political views on everything? Absolutely not.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So to get involved in that, I try to keep my personal views personal.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
But at the same time, I have to think about... being the leader of our nation, I have to just respect that office for what it is
mm-hmm.
on my behalf. And the reason why is because my clients, the people I support, have different views.
Yeah,
so
absolutely.
I cannot, you know, let them, you know, feel like I'm going to be partial
pushing
because of this
yes,
or that.
For
so
beliefs.
I just, yes, for yes. my personal beliefs. So my job is just to help them. So I feel like in awe. Maybe someday we'll all do, you know, some case studies on on what these years have been like, these last 4 years, you know, and who knows what the next 4 years are going to be. But essentially, I think the whole Twitter age and how we, you know, our president has started, so fake news, for example. I mean, like, you know, have we all known that news is fake? Obviously. Forever. So sometimes I think TMZ is the only real news, you know? They seem like they
found out Kobe before anything happened.
Exactly. What? They found out everything.
The plane just hit.
Right. And I can't think of the one that my kids, they use all the time, but it's more self-reporting.
Okay.
One of the news outlets, but anyway, I can't think of what it is, but anyway, so yeah, the president uses Twitter to get classified information. Now, it's just interesting, you know, how wow, he's tweeting at, you know, 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. Okay. All right. That's different.
What are you really doing?
I don't even really get on Twitter, so I will never know what's going on. But the way the news media actually takes, you know, things that are happening in social media, and they will broadcast that. Mm-hmm, so back in my day of learning as a student, you know, you have to go through so many different hoops to get on, you know, classified news. Yes. So now things are reported instantly. You know, you and I can actually sit here and record things on my own phones. So, you know, but, you know, I think that it is important that we teach children how to have good manners, be respectful of whoever, you know, they are, person is, whether we agree with them or not, just respect people for being human beings.
Yes.
And then I think it's important that we demonstrate that the way we live. Adults, before we can get all over children, adults have got to stop doing the cyberbullying thing. Yes, we have got to. We have got to. And, you know, it's okay to vent, but I mean, after all, it's social media. So, you know, at the end of the day, you know, hey, you can deal with people face to face. That's a healthy thing.
Yes.
In which I will say that with the COVID-19, you know, we are limited on our social interaction. Mm-hmm. So even just being here with you right now, it's good to get out of the norm of, you know, of what we just been so, like, I'm like, I'm not used to being so asleep, you know, sleeping all the time. So hopefully we can get out and do some healthy things and get ourselves together. I saw you doing the floor exercises too, by the way. And I was like, okay, all right, I got to get
make
that routine together.
Put the whole thing, whole workout plan together for people and everything. So it's been very interesting. I'm like, oh, I've been waiting for this time because I've got so many things online I haven't even published, so people don't even know.
Really?
So, I'm like, okay, this is what it's probably the perfect time.
That's
so
let's
get that taken care of. But I'm not going to hold you any longer. I thank you so much.
Thank you for having
so
me.
So much.
It's
absolutely.
Pleasure.
And so, how can people find you? I'm going to let you go ahead and tell people how they can find you on the social media outlets.
Okay.
Your business.
Absolutely. So, follow me on Facebook. Solutions for Success is my Facebook name for my business. You can find me there. Inbox me. Get the messages instantly. You can make an appointment also. And Marcy Watkins, you can follow me there on Facebook. I try to post inspirational messages. My husband and I have date night quite often, so hopefully we can get some great marital examples and tips. After 25 years of marriage, it's been awesome. And you can catch me that way. All of my business information is online.
All right, perfect. This is your man, your host, E. Gray, on the E36 Unfiltered Live YouTube page. We'll see you soon in podcast. Thank you.